Okay, Stu.
Excuse me, how much the loco weigh?
About 120 tonnes, something like that.
Oh, I guess 100.
Something like that, yeah. And the table itself's about 40 tonnes.
Is it?
Yeah, something like that.
Take some pushing then.
It's not too bad if you get it balanced.
Oh, I see. Is that what you were doing earlier?
Yeah, you've got to get the engine right, otherwise you just can't shift it.
Oh, I see.
It all sits on a little pivot about the size of your hand.
Oh, right.
In the middle, a very small pivot.
Yeah.
I noticed when you took the lever off when you was at the other thing, it did...
It balanced a bit more,
yeah.
It's just got a catch that goes in underneath the ground.
Right.
We're only turning it to show the turntable off, really. We'll turn it back again.
We usually use the steam off the engine on some of them.
On some of them, yeah. This is an original Great Western one. It came from Bethwelly in North Wales.
Oh, yeah, no.
And it got lengthened with length in it. When we restored it, we put the pit in. We made it slightly bigger than it was originally.
Yeah, because that's the end of the line, the same
thing. End of the line, yeah. And end of like this manner would have run there, you see.
Yeah.
So it fits on it perfectly. So.
Probably the same one when I was a kid. It used to be
used to run up and down that swing quite a lot on the Cambrian. Used to run around a lot.
Yeah, we used to do double-headed from Snow Hill in Birmingham.
Yes, that's right, yeah.
Sometimes in the 50s.
Possible destination, wouldn't it?
Cracking scenery as well.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. It's lovely along the coast there, yeah. Keep going. Put it back around the right way then. We've done a turn of king on it. Yeah, just overhangs both ends. Once you've got it moving, it's alright, like now.
Yeah.
Got the weight going.
Yeah. So just preferring demonstration.
Wow.
Is
that not?
They're
not touching the other, we haven't quite got it back off. No, it's not too bad. You should have them all off the ground.